Okay, we have arrived at our stopping point in Grand Cayman. Grand Cayman is a tenderfoot, meaning there is no pier. So we anchor up and then shuttles bring us back and forth. Assuming this is a shuttle boat right here for us. But what's more interesting is what's going on over there. It seems to be like fuel things and all this water's coming out. Hopefully it doesn't affect us. Okay, the boat is still moving a little. Not 2 hours ago even, it was kind of crappy and like it has been up and on. But then we got right in this area and boom, nice. Sun is out, whole thing. So I gotta go pack us a beach bag. We're going to the turtle farm, and that includes some beach time apparently and getting in the water with some baby turtles. Bus in Georgetown, I think it's Georgetown. Anyway, the Grand Cayman.
Yeah.
And we are on our way to an excursion called Turtles, Turtles, Turtles.
We advise you get your camera ready as we have a few surprises coming up shortly. So get them cameras ready.
Camera engaged. There's a tender right there. We ate there at Rackman's. That's where we ate, and all those fish were right there by us.
Well, coming up shortly on your left, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to Coming up shortly on your left, like I want to introduce you to Cayman's comfort food. Back in the days, when this restaurant opened here, no one wanted to eat here. But after some time now, it has become Cayman's comfort food. Also, a restaurant of this type has the best view here on the waterfront. It's a surprise. Coming up on your left, ladies and gentlemen, we have here home of the Whopper, Burger King. Well, I agree you have a Burger King, but do you have a waterfront Burger King? Well, it's the only waterfront Burger King here. Then shortly on your left, we have Lobster Pot Restaurant, Wine and Bar for the best seafood here, that is Lobster Pot. Then coming up shortly on your right, we have Pork Market and Pork Pharmacy.
Oh yeah, no parking.
We basically have three local supermarket chains here on this island, and that is Pork, Foster's and Harley's. Now, Pork and Harley's have one location each, while Foster's have six, so altogether we have eight local supermarkets here. Now,
the
on
cemetery.
The right, ladies and gentlemen, we have our local ESO, the price you see listed there, that's in our local currency. In US, that is $8 for a gallon. Yes, the price so high here, been killing us here, that's why we decided to build the cemetery across the fuel station. A lot of people dropped dead there with the price, man.
A tree fell, oh no, that's a fence, fell down. Oh, Plumeria, that's an old
then
one.
Then shortly on your right,
Dixie Cemetery.
We have KFC, which is known to you as Kentucky Fried Chicken, but here in the Caribbean we say, keep from cooking.
Keep from
then on our left,
cooking.
We have this
okay,
wonderful
okay.
Fine dining restaurant. It's called The Wharf. It was established in 1988.
The Wharf. Okay.
And also on your left, we have going up now, Grand Hyatt. And Grand Hyatt, this hotel is estimated to complete by the end of 2024.
Wow.
Now on your left,
that'd
on the sidewalk, there is this little brown sign. It says beach access. So right here on your left, this is where the 7 miles beach actually begins. Captain's Bakery, Force Bakery here on the island. of St. Matthew Medical University, and it isn't to be the only one here in the Caribbean. Across from there, we have the World Gym, and then across from the World Gym, we have Pizza Boat. What a great way to treat yourself after you finish from the gym, a slice of pizza, right? Then we have 7 Mile Shop. In this little plaza, we can basically find everything here. Liquor, souvenir, clothing, everything is over there. Then on your left, we have here Margaritaville Beach Resort. Unfortunately, back in 2020, when COVID came here, they closed their doors. So little or nothing going on there right now.
Just like in Biloxi, they closed down.
We also have Sunset Cove, Crescent Point, and Plantation Village. These are all condominiums along on your left.
That looks like a nice resort. Big tennis court. It's too hot to play tennis
then
in the Caribbean for me.
We have this hotel here by the name of Hampton by Hilton. This here, ladies and gentlemen, this was once a comfort suite, which was the cheapest hotel here. A gentleman here by the name of Mr. Dart, he bought this property, did some renovation, changed the name, and now it become the third most expensive hotel. It was once the cheapest. Very smart, right?
Hampton is.
On our left, Marriott Resort, and then shortly on our right, we have Pepper's Bar and Grill for the best jerk chicken, jerk pork, jerk sausages. That is Pepper's.
So all these big resorts are not that far from the little main area downtown. Break time.
Yes, we
go. That looks pretty. Cow. Oh, there's an ice cream shop back there.
Well, at this time, I would advise you take a look to your far left. You will see this very big and beautiful home all the way inside there. A family of five living inside there, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow.
Yes, I can only imagine. They probably employ more people to clean that place than who live in it, right? Beautiful hotel here, it's called Caribbean Club. They also have an amazing fine dining restaurant. It's called Luca. So we are currently on the 7 miles beach stretch, and this is where you'll find most of our hotels,
7 mile
condos,
beach. Okay.
Villas,
lots of people take excursions to 7 mile beach. They see all these public access, so seems like you could just, you know, not have to
now,
go with the
group. Straight ahead of us, we have the store from building. On your left is said to be the residence. On your right is the lobby. This is the Ritz-Carlton, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful 5-star hotel here. They also have a great 5-star restaurant here. It's called Sevens, right here on your left.
Mm-hmm.
And the Ritz-Carlton here was built and owned by Mr. Gar. Same gentleman that bought the Comfort Suite. We just hopped on by Hilton. Resort and spa. Very beautiful resort here. Then coming up shortly on your left, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Governor's Residence.
The Governor's Residence.
So on your left here.
Oh yeah, I can see
this. This is where the Governor currently resides.
On the waterfront.
Then across from there, we have here Governor's Beach. And Governor's Beach
right
here
next door
is also open to the public. Now, the Cayman Islands, ladies and gentlemen, we are basically a British overseas territory. We're still ruled and governed under the law of the British. For example, we do not vote for a governor here. We have no say in our governor that we receive here. We basically receive our governor straight from England. When our queen was there, every 4 years, she would normally appoint a governor and send him or her to rule over us. Our current governor right now is Mistress Jade Owen. She came here on the 24th of April and she was appointed or chosen by the king. Now this building that's going up here, both on your left and on your right, this will be the Four Seasons. I'm sure this is where you want to stay on your next visit to the Cayman Islands, right? Well, that is also owned by Mr. Dart. Then on our left, we have the famous Seven Miles Public Beach.
Oh wow, look at that.
Then also going up on your left, this will be Indigo Hotel. And Indigo Hotel is also owned by Mr. Dart. So you've been hearing a lot about Mr. Dart, right?
Yeah.
I soon give you the full story of Mr. Dart.
We're going to one of those roundabouts.
Now, coming up shortly on your left, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to Kimpton Sea Fire. Kimpton Sea Fire was opened here back in November 2016. And here, it sits on the 7 miles beach itself. Yes, it is also owned by Mr. Dart. So the story behind Mr. Dart currently owns 43% of this island.
Wow.
43% of this island. And Mr. Dart is an American.
Wow.
More than 35 years ago, Mr. Dart had a case with the IRS where he sued them for a couple of millions. After he won that case, that's when he moved here to the Cayman Islands, where he doesn't pay any
taxes.
Mr. Dart even have his own city here. It's called Cayman Bay. The locals here refer to Cayman Bay as Dart City. On our way back to Georgetown, we will drive by Cayman Bay or Dart City. Cayman Islands was discovered by Christopher Columbus, and that was May 10th, 1503. When Columbus discovered these islands, he called them Las Tortugas. Can anyone tell me why would he want to name them that? Amazing, that's correct. He named them after the green sea turtles he saw surrounding these islands. Now, Back in the days, ladies and gentlemen, the merchants, including the pirates that would normally travel in the Caribbean Sea, they would normally stop on these islands to get meat. And that meat was nothing other than the green sea turtles. Because in those days, there wasn't any chicken or any beef. So the green sea turtle was their main protein.
Did I say turtle?
Cayman Islands consists or made up of three beautiful islands. We have here Grand Cayman, which is the largest among the three.
All that water, just then we have Cayman Brac, so pretty.
Little Cayman. Grand Cayman here is said to be 22 miles long from one end to the next, 4 miles to the widest point, a total of 76 square miles. Here on Grand Cayman, we have a population of approximately 68,000 people. Out of that 68,000, only about 32,000 are natives here, the Caymanians. The rest are basically expats living and working here. We also have over 135 different nationalities living here. So basically, people from all across the globe living and working on these islands. Cayman Brac have just around 10,000, and Little Cayman just around 3,000 people. Now, shortly on your left, we have West Bay Cemetery. Across on your right, West Bay Fire Station. Now, does anyone observe anything about our cemetery here?
Above ground.
That's right, they're all above ground. Also, they're located on the beach. And the reason why, once you dig 3 to 4 feet, water will be coming up. Then back in the days, no one wanted to live on the waterfront. Because in those days, there wasn't any hurricane tracker. Now today, waterfront property become the most expensive property, not only here in Cayman, but anywhere else around the world. On our left, Foster's, and this is also one out of the three local supermarket chains here. And they basically have 6 locations on island. Then, on your left, we have this little beautiful home here. It's called Old Homestead. This is basically what the old Caymanian style home used to look like. And this home, ladies and gentlemen, it's been here for a number of years now. It basically withstood all the natural disaster that the Cayman Islands face for a number of years now. And with little repair, that home still standing there beautiful. That home was constructed from a technique called a walkaround. So wattle is basically a type of hardwood, or they also call it ironwood. A daub is basically coral reef. They will crush it, making it a base, and then they plaster the hardwood. Now at this time, you want to take a look to your far left. You may be able to see your ship. That is George Dock. That is where we are coming from. Also right here is the end of the 7 mile speed stretch. Well, I'm sure you may want to ask me how long is the 7 mile speech. Well, it's actually 6.3 miles. It's not 7 miles. The reason why they call it 7 mile speech, back in the days before any accurate measurement was done, it was said to be one of the longest beach in the Caribbean. So that's how we get its name, 7 mile speech. They estimate the distance of it.
Captive in the little petting thing, aren't they? says, dude, see if we figure our way out of here. The other one, not this one. I'm trying to get to this one. He's fast. It's a bigger one and lighter. It's two fingers, it says. Smaller. These guys are a little tough to lose. Look at the bigger chunks. Coming here. Look how big this one is. There's an iguana. Oh, he's giving me the stink eye. I'm not going to hurt you. I know the dangerous little roosters here that are just right over there. Wouldn't be the Caribbean without a rooster. That's a pretty one.
All right, guys.
Shooting through a thing, but that's the snorkeling lagoon. I'll get it outside. But we are in a place where you can get drinks and food. Since I don't eat breakfast, I'm hungry. Let's see what's for lunch. Oh, the breeze. I see mahi-mahi sign. Oh, these must be drinks. Yeah, these are alcohol. Coming to have lunch with me? Yeah, tell them. Tell your friends. Sure, just go ahead. Conch fritters. And Caesar salad. So that's the lagoon I got in. And it has a little channel all the way around, or little whatever. Little river, almost like. To in front of the restaurant. The part I was in, there's no wildlife. I think it's all up more closer to the restaurant. And I never did see any. I never got quite far enough. Yeah, I probably got to about right there. And I think you have to be in this more open area up there. Because I guess the coldness of the water, it's a little chilly when you get in, but you get used to it. But anyway, it must have made my hands shrink, but my wedding ring fell off. And then my other ring was coming off. I caught it though. And so it was really difficult getting that ring back. So I sort of exhausted myself doing that. So now it's almost time to go. So we are going to maybe hit the gift shop. If I came back again, I think I'd go to the beach part and forget trying to swim with the turtles, because he said if you're wearing jewelry or you have toenail polish on, they might harass you a little bit. So that kind of had me on end edge too. But it's a cool place nonetheless. Oh, there's a lifeguard there. And I don't know what all these little houses are. They just say no entry. Oh, they're offices and stuff. And that's where we had lunch. There's a lot of different things. There's a lot of turtles in like holding pens, so you can see the different ages of them, because this is a turtle farm. They do release, raise the babies, and they have males and females together and married, and then a beach for them to lay their eggs. And they have snorkeling, they have everything. The snorkeling is actually free. I paid $4 extra to get a full face mask, and the whole ring fiasco caused me to get a lot of water, some water in my eyes, so that was unpleasant. It could have been a great experience, I just messed it all up. But anyway, it's just nice here. And then they have a little food court if you don't want to go in the restaurant where we went. Oh, it's the hatchery, education and hatchery. Don't really have a lot of time for all of that. Oh, a selfie spot.
So cute.
Okay, so they do have an educational component here. And there's behind this wall is a video playing, so I'm being quiet, and some other interactive stuff. So the hatchery part is not open. Green, Kemps, Foxtail, Loggerhead. We have those leatherbacks. I think we have green and loggerheads in Florida. I guess these are for kids to sit on. There's a few of them around. All right, gift shop, yes. Splash gift shop. It's another plumeria. The plumeria don't look as healthy here as they do like in Hawaii and Florida. Could be the time of year or something. Dry season or something, I don't know. What is this over here? Oh, that's where we started. It's with the big turtles and the gift shop. You can buy turtle food right there. And, you know, soda or something. All right, so they finished all this construction that was going on when I was here before, and they have turned this street, which is right across from this terminal, cruise ship terminal, not the one we're at, we're at the other one down the road about 100 meters. They've turned it into all pedestrian, just like Antigua, St. Kitts, I think, a couple of them have. So a lot of tourist stores and stuff here. And yeah, easy to walk and not worry about traffic. I think we're about to see a chicken cross the road. Oh boy, that's probably not a good thing. Yeah, I do, kinda. Yeah, let me go to Pandora first. I hope this chicken doesn't cross the road. All right, so we're going in this little, I forgot what it's called, island. It starts with the Savorsky, and then the cigars. And sometimes people get their internet in here. This is Christmas wrapping. Really loud. But we are going to Pandora. Okay. Sunless man. I think there's an upstairs to this, or there used to be. Ice cream store. Oh, they have sandwiches made up already. Ooh. And then pineapple's what I want. You want? Oh, it's gelato mostly. Ooh, those are pretty. Size of those brownies, honey. What is that? A meringue. Gelato. Those moose cakes, aren't they pretty? And there is a chicken that wants in here. Never had an ice cream cone that long before. So this is where we got very delicious gelato. Gelato and Co. And it's on that street they redid. Kind of went around the block to get to. Santa's a giveaway.
Grand Cayman from the waterfront perspective. So what is this, mussels?
Is it mussels, honey? Or clams?
Little necks.
Oh, little necks, that's right. Greek salad. And I'm having corn fritters. We're both having the sliced beef tenderloin. Came with carrots and I think potatoes. Okay, so this is a warm cherry streusel with vanilla sauce and sliced almonds.